Pretty Wills here. Gonna go over a week 5 premium newsletter play, which you can subscribe to my newsletter on freddywills.com. Link in the show notes. Make sure you also subscribe to my podcast on iTunes by searching College Football Betting, and you'll get another free pick on Friday. I have a 10-minute segment there, Friday commute. So let's get on to it. Week 4 recap. Between college and pro football, I went 9-6 against the spread. Plus 14.75% return on investment, and I hit on all three of my max plays. So we're now actually 2-2 on our premium newsletter picks and 4-0 on our free picks, which is the pick I give out my Friday commute podcast. So make sure you tune into those. Today we're talking about Florida State versus Wake Forest. I'm going to take Florida State here, -7.5. You can get some -7s out there right now, but I'm going to do the right thing and give out 7.5. It's going to be 3.5% play out of 5.5 as being the max play. This is a Florida State game. I think that they're going to get back on track finally after starting the season 0-2. Who would have thought that they would have been 0-2 and Wake Forest would have been 4-0? Florida State's offense has looked awful so far. The offensive line has been very bad protecting the quarterback so far. Now, keep in mind, they faced two of the best defenses in the country in NC State and Alabama. They also had to deal with time off, and it was evident that they were a little rusty last week. They also had a couple injuries. A linebacker went out in the first half, and then Auden Tate went back out in the first half at wide receiver, who started the game with 8 receptions. Both should be back this week. They're actually day-to-day, but I do believe they'll be back. With or without them, I feel confident in this bet. This week they will face Wake Forest, who's actually 125th at getting to the quarterback with a 1.52% sack rate. I think James Blackman could have a big game here at quarterback for Florida State. Blackman might be a better passer than DeAndre Francois, who they lost against Alabama for the season. He's actually definitely a better leader. If you go back to that game, he actually gave the pre-game speech to the team. And to me, that speaks volumes for a freshman and for a quarterback. The backup quarterback, given the speech, I think this team rallies this week. Let's take a look at Wake Forest here. And before we get to that, Florida State still has everything to play for. They went out. They get to the ACC championship game. They win the ACC championship game. They're in the college football playoff. Wake Forest, on the other hand, has played above and beyond what was expected here at 4-0. They come into the game 4-0, 3-1 against the spread. Florida State 0-2 against the spread. So you know you're getting a little bit of line value here. Definitely getting it, because when you look back at the last 2 years, the line was 23.5 and 18 points. And we have a Florida State team going into the season supposed to be their best team in the last 3 years, of course. So Wake Forest has had some misleading wins, so let's go over them here. Wake Forest beat Boston College 34-10 in week 2 as a pick. So they won by 24 points against the spread. However, in that game, they only had 309 total yards of offense. They were plus 4 yards in total yards against Boston College. They were lucky enough to be plus 4 in turnover margin, which really turned the game. And as we've said, Blackman at quarterback, Florida State, he didn't have any interceptions last week. I think he takes care of the ball. I think they get the running game going this week. BC also had not looked good this season at all. BC's defense is ranked 79th, allowing 5.7 yards per play. But here, they were able to hold Wake Forest offense under their season average to just 4.35 yards per play. So that really spoke volumes to me. And then last week, Wake Forest against Appalachian State, they were lucky to hold them with a last-minute missed field goal. Otherwise, they lose that game. They won it 20-19. I actually gave out Appalachian State plus 6 as a premium play, which cashed. Appalachian State really dominated this game, plus 150 total yards. They struggled in the red zone, obviously. 2.86 points per trip inside Wake's territory. I don't see that happening with Florida State. Worth noting, before the game, Appalachian State was actually struggling big time on offense. They were ranked 89th, or they're ranked 89th now, 353 yards per game. They got 494 yards in that game against Wake Forest. Maybe Wake Forest was peeking ahead to Florida State, but still, I don't think so, because in the last few years, we know Appalachian State is given some of the Power 5 teams a run for their money. So I think they were pretty focused on that game. Very fortunate to get out of there with a win. This should be a very good sign for Florida State's offense, in my opinion, to have a breakout performance. I am expecting double-digit victory on the road here. And Jimbo Fisher is a very good coach, very good quarterback coach. So I think they'll be just fine. Again, as a reminder, head on over to freddywills.com and subscribe to my premium newsletter pick, which goes up on Thursdays. So you'll get an email. It's one email once per week. I do not spam you. And also head on over to iTunes, search College Football Betting, and make sure you subscribe to my two weekly podcasts. Thanks, everyone, and good luck this week.